This is from Elma, and I've never thought about this question before. Why didn't God put tithing in one of the Ten Commandments? Well, I don't know, Elma, but your question brings up a chance to bring up the different kinds of law and instruction in the Bible. This is a very important to understand these different types. They're not all given for the same purpose. In general, there are moral laws, like the Ten Commandments, which are forever. They will never fade away. They will always be important. The next kind of law that is given in the scriptures are ceremonial and some of the dietary laws, which were fulfilled in Jesus Christ. And so therefore, they're no longer relevant to us. And there are some cultural laws that were given by God for a time as needed at a particular time in a particular culture. Again, they are not so relevant for us anymore. And then there are also principles that are valid forever, such as the principle of the tithe. The tithe isn't a law, it's simply a principle. The tithe wasn't given as a moral command, but as an explanation and a way of prioritizing God and receiving His blessing or His curse in the way we respond. It was an explanation how we should look at our money as really God's money, especially that first 10% of the portion, and how God wanted to use our money to build a relationship with us according to our response. So this is what it says in Malachi chapter 3, verses 8 through 10. Will a man rob God? Yet you are robbing me. But you say, how have we robbed you? And I say, in the tithes and the offerings. You are cursed with a curse, for you are robbing me, the whole nation of you. Bring the whole tithe into the storehouse. The storehouse was a place in the temple where those things could be stored to be used by the Levitical priests and others, the poor and so on and so forth. That there may be food in my house. Test me now on this, says the Lord of hosts. If I will not open for you the windows of heaven and pour out for you a blessing until it overflows. So this is a promise from God. And He simply wants us to understand that that first 10%, according to how He's thinking, isn't even for us to mess with. All of our money's God's. We are to steward it all in a way that pleases God. But we are not to mess with that first 10%.